I'd like to talk about another interesting data structure that's very useful for two-dimensional data and can be expanded to multi-dimensional data, whatever the dimension is you desire. We're going to do it with just two-dimensional data, and this is called a quad tree. So with a KD tree, where K equals 2, the idea is every time you insert a new piece of data to the tree, you are going to divide your two-dimensional space into two partitions, things that are less than or equal to the point that you've just entered, or things that are greater than the point you just entered. With the quad tree, instead, every time you insert a point to the quad tree, you divide the space that's available into four unequal-sized quadrants. So let's just go ahead and start to insert this so that you can see what I'm talking about. So my first data item to insert is a 3-7. So x is 3, y is 7. So here's my 3-7 point right here. Now this 3-7 is being inserted to an empty root. So that'll be the first node that I enter into my quad tree. Okay, now what this 3-7 does is it divides the available space right here into four quadrants, and that's where the name quad comes from in quad tree. And those quadrants are identified using this picture right here where you have northeast, southeast, southwest, northwest of the point that you just inserted. So these will be the four children of a data value that you insert. When I create a node, it'll have four children, not just two children as in the KD tree. So these four children are going to correspond to these four quadrants, and let's just do it in clockwise order starting at the 1 o'clock position. The order doesn't really matter as long as you're consistent, use the same order every time. So I'm going to just write like a little legend up here so I can keep track of what the children refer to down below when I'm actually building a quad tree. Okay, so there are my four children right there, in order, clockwise order, starting at the 1 o'clock position, northeast position. Okay, so the next node I'm going to insert will be the 8-1 coordinate. So 8-1 goes right into this quadrant here. And this quadrant, looking down the tree, starting here at this node, we can see that that quadrant is in the northeast quadrant. So to insert it, I need to go down the first child location. So here are the children. And I'll go down the northeast child, and that's where I put in my 8-1 node. We can see right away this will be a much more shallow and bushier tree than the KD tree because I have the possibility of four children rather than only two children. Okay, this new node right here divides its available space into four uneven quadrants. Now obviously I'm not going to cross here because if I cross going this way, that says something about the root node, and the root node has decided that everything to the left of it goes into one pair of quadrants and everything to the right goes into a different pair of quadrants. So by the time I get to the right, this quadrant right here is no longer an option for making my decision once I pass down to the next level here. So I've inserted the 8-1, now let me insert my 6-6. My 6-6 goes right here. So first I look at my root node and I go down to here. So I'm in this quadrant compared to the root node right here, and I go into position 6-6 right here, which in comparison to this node is in the southwest quadrant, okay? So the children then of what I just inserted here, I'm in the southwest quadrant, which is the third one down. Okay, so that's my 6-6, goes to that position there. You know, I think it'll be useful for me to number these nodes as I insert them, and let me do that in a different color, so it becomes very obvious. There's 1, and this was 2, and this is 3, and I'll circle those so they stand out a little bit. Okay, next node to insert, let's see, I just did the 6-6. Next node to insert is the 2-6 right here. So I compare to the first node, which is my root node. I go 6-6 is going to be in this location right here. So compared to the first node, I am in the northwest quadrant, Okay, so I look here for my northwest quadrant. It's empty, so I will insert my six, my 2-6 right there as the new leaf at that point. So that was my fourth node that I inserted. Okay. And that node right there divided its area. It's like the 4 is like an exemplar for this whole area right here, and it also serves to divide that area into our 4 quadrants. Okay, so the next is a 1-7. 1-7 compared to 3-7. 1-7 goes here. Okay. Well, I'm on the border, so I'll have to make a decision about which is less than or equal to. So 1-7 is compared to the 1 is, let's call that the smaller direction. So I'm going to move it up into that quadrant. So 1-7 goes into the northwest quadrant, right? So the northwest quadrant, so it's going up into this quadrant right here. So then I compare my 1-7 against the 4 node right here. So 1-7 is in the 4 node's southwest quadrant. Let me make sure I did that right. Hang on. So I'm looking to insert 1-7, which is located right here, compared to the root. It is in the northwest quadrant, because I'm doing less than or equal. Okay, so it's the northwest quadrant. So this is the exemplar for the northwest quadrant right here. That's my 2-6. And in my 2-6 node, it is, compared to that node, it is in the southwest quadrant. If this is where my 2-6 is right here, the new node I'm inserting, 1-7, is in the southwest quadrant. So let me add those children on. Okay, southwest is the third one. So that's my new node, 1-7. Okay, and so 1-7 is the fifth node that I'm entering. Right there, 5. Okay, so that's going to serve to divide this into sort of 4 quadrants. This quadrant right here is the one underneath, but the one that's between 7 and 8, the Y line 7 and 8 is not going to be significant. That'll always go make a decision based on the 1. Okay, next one to enter is the 8-6. The 8-6 goes right here. Okay, that's where the 8-6 goes. Remember, I'm choosing to put it on the less than side. So the 8-6 compared to the 3-7, 8-6 compared to 3-7, there's my 3-7. The 8-6 is in the northeast quadrant, so I go down the northeast side. That's here. So now I'm looking here. I'm in this quadrant. The 8-6 compared to that point right there, let's see, it is in that quadrant there, so it's in the southwest quadrant of that point. Southwest is right here. Okay, so it's in this quadrant. Put in this quadrant right here, so that's southwest. Okay, compared to the 6-6, which is right here, 6-6 subdivided it like so. So this point right here is in the northeast quadrant of the 3-point. So let's see where I need my children from the 6-6. And I do the northeast quadrant, and that gives me my 8-6 point. Northeast. Okay, and then I have the 5-9, and the 5-9 goes right here. So compared to the 3-7, that is in the southeast quadrant. Southeast quadrant is this empty child right here, so that's where I will insert my 5-9. Okay, let me go through here and number all the points so that you can see them. Okay, so we have, I'll do it, I guess, right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is 1, and that's 1. And then 8-1 was 2, and that's my 2 here. And then 6-6 was 3. There's the 3 right there with my 6-6. That was 3, the third point that I entered. The 2-6 was 4. Let's see, 2, 6, there's my 4 right there. Okay, the 1, 7 was 5. 1, 7 is 5 right there. Okay, 8, 6 was 6. There's the 8, 6 right there. Okay, and the 5, 9 was the 7 point. 7th point to be entered. And there it is right there. Okay.